Do you worry that robotics are going to take over our jobs? As, of course, people get worried when they hear about robotics. We keep hearing these expectations that there will be more robots than humans in 20 or 30 years.
I don't know if that's true or not. What I do know is a couple of things. First of all, if AI automates everything, I'm pretty sure the software engineering jobs are going to be the last ones to go, because those are the people that are going to be writing the code that's automating the stuff.
That's true.
That's first of all. But second of all, I think, you know, historically, it's always been really easy to envision the jobs that disappear, but impossible to predict the jobs that get created. So today, people are talking a lot about Bitcoin and cryptocurrency. Nobody had ever heard of that a few years ago, but think about all of the jobs that are being created right now in that industry. The iPhone was invented only 10 years ago. That's nothing, right? And so 10 years ago, the idea of an entire multi-billion dollar industry being built on apps didn't even exist.
Wow.
So as technology grows, we can't even conceive of what jobs it creates. So, of course, we're going to have to grapple with the impact of things like self-driving cars on the trucking industry. And we're going to have to invest in continual training for our workforce, right? The world is a different place. You can't go to college and learn for 4 years and work for the rest of your life. You have to invest in continually training yourself. That being said, technology has a way of kind of expanding the universe and creating more opportunity. We just can't see that far ahead, and we have to be willing to learn as it comes.
Right. I mean, you don't want your doctor to ever stop learning, right?
That's right.
You want to make sure that your doctor is up on the latest trends and the latest things to keep you in good health. You don't want to ever stop learning.
Absolutely.
As the world is changing.
That's right. But unfortunately, our current education system is not really built to allow that, right? Going to school is really expensive, and it takes a really, really long time,
yeah.
2 to 4 years. Tons of money. You have to quit your job, and that's kind of what we're trying to build at Flatiron School, a world in which people can actually make learning part of their lives and part of their careers by providing courses that are flexible, but also fast and intensive, designed specifically to upskill them in the areas that they need.
This is a really important point, because I was going to ask you that. Tell me about the curriculum and sort of how long you go to the Flatiron School for, because this is not like a four-year college talking about. You can go and you can get trained in a short period of time.
Yes, our on-campus programs are 15 weeks long. So students come in and they're there all day, every day for 15 weeks, and then they go into the job placement programs. We also have online programs that are entirely flexible. They'll go at your own pace. Some students will finish those programs in 3 months. Others will finish them in 10 months, right? If you're a working mom and you only have time on evenings and weekends to work on it, it might take you longer. But again, anybody can do it. It's just about putting in the hours.
Yeah, it's just about putting in the hours, but the industries out there that are looking for coders and mm-hmm. software engineers, are there industries that you see that are more in demand for that kind of skill set than others? Who's hiring coders?
It's everybody.
Really?
Of course. I can't think of a single industry right now that it has not been entirely transformed by technology, by code, in the past 10 years.
Well, one is healthcare, and we know that. I mean, you've got, you know, semiconductor chips in your bloodstream right now. I mean,
yeah.
You've got chips all over your body to track everything.
That's right. It's moving so fast. I mean, even industries you might not expect, right? Like, people talk about media and journalism, right? Most of us consume our news on apps today.
Yes.
Right? So even media companies have giant teams of software engineers building those apps. You know, whatever stores you shop at that send you emails, somebody's building that. Somebody's making those databases. So literally any industry you can imagine. And that's also what's helped, I think, increase things like diversity and especially gender parity, is the realization that you know, it's not just about kind of, you know, inventing semiconductors. While that's important, you can pursue your passion, whatever it might be, whether it's fashion or media or accounting, if that's your thing, while being a software engineer.
Yeah. You had a supermodel go through Flatiron?
Yes, Carly Kloss is one of our students, and she's an incredible inspiration. She funded scholarships for young women around the country. So she created something called Code with Klossy that we work on.
That's right,
with
yeah.
on her. Free summer camps for high school girls around the country.
That is awesome.
It's amazing. It's amazing to see. And that's exactly kind of what we need in this world, is people like that showing that technology is accessible. Yeah. It's a way to build an amazing career. And you can do it while pursuing whatever you're passionate about.
Well, when you look at the wages, we're all talking about that's wages. Right. This is another big point here to make, because we've been waiting for wages to move. They haven't moved in years. And in fact, when you have a degree in coding or software engineering, you will actually get a job that's much higher paying yep. than other jobs. What's the salary typically?
So we take outcomes reporting very seriously. So we actually invented something called independently audited jobs reports. We have CPAs review all of our outcomes. So you can download our full jobs reports on our websites. Students leave Flatiron School and go into a variety of paths, from apprenticeships to internships to full-time salaried roles. Students who accept full-time salaried roles have an average salary of $75,000 a year.
That was Maria Bartiromo with Flatiron School CEO Adam Enbar.